Oshoga Bam joins us now. He is a member of the PDP from our studios in Abuja. Good morning, and thank you for joining us today. Well, we understand that, at least from Alhaji Golak, that all is well with the preparations for the Congress, which is going to happen anytime, I mean, in May, as he tells us. Do you share that opinion?
My great pleasure to be here, first and foremost. Secondly, I want to make it categorically clear that I have watched my friend Ahmed Golak trying to distort the principles of governing of the party, which is not true, which is not factual, which is an imagination of his own self. Anybody who is comfortable with the history of PDP from 1999 or before 1999, when there was a struggle by some patriotic Nigerians from the G7, led by late Alhaji Abubakar Rimi and other patriots that built the G18 and G34, when Alice Ekweme came into the mainstream of the organization, and subsequently the PDP was registered by former military president General Abdusalam Abubakar, and then other decisions were taken, which is one, the rotation of the presidency of Nigeria, two, the zoning principle of the party. And fundamentally, why zoning was entrenched was, if you could remember vividly, was to appease the anointment of June 12th. That was the principal reason, the reason why zoning was entrenched. So that our Southwest brothers and sisters who feel offended by the anointment of June 12th was accommodated. So the zoning and the rotation of presidency was entrenched day one, even before the registration of the PDP. It was part of their fundamental objective to keep Nigeria together, to give everybody a sense of belonging, irrespective of your tribe, minority or majority. Everybody was accommodated, everybody was given a sense of belonging. So it is not true that some of the offices he's talking about are only offices that need to be zoned. In an organized system, in a party where you have people who are passionate, who understand the dynamics of Nigeria, who appreciated the geographical locations of Nigeria, the sensitivity of the people that are involved, they ought to sit down and look at all those options and deal with them accordingly and interlock them in the strategic interest of the country, because our aim is to build a very viable political structure, a very viable nation, a viable economy that can keep the country going. So he has been struggling to distort the fact, which is not correct. And the issue of the zoning that he's talking about, no decision has been reached. Decision was reached in Akwa Ibom. It's because that it was overheated and people overreacted, and they have no option then to suspend it for the time being. Otherwise, there are groups that are really making a lot of effort to take a lot of harsh action on that, because nobody have a monopoly of PDP. PDP is a party well entrenched in the history of Nigeria, presided over the affairs of Nigeria for 16 years. So nobody will be allowed to come and distort history, distort facts, because of his own selfish interest. And also, to state clearly that Ali Sheriff wasn't elected by the whole neck. He was imposed by few neck people. I was one of the contestants of the national chairman of PDP. Ali Sheriff wasn't nominated by Borno State. The person that was nominated by Borno State ESCO of the party is the former FCT minister, Abagana. I was nominated from Bauchi State. Ambassador Wilberforce Jutta from Adamawa State. And then you have Senator Girgir from Yobe State. It is only Saidu Kumu, also from Gombe State. It is only Taraba that did not nominate anybody. I was part of the process. I wasn't saying story. I'm saying facts of what happened.
So what is the group asking for?
Fairness and justice. You can't just sit down and say that you have zoned positions just to satisfy a few interests. Positions are meant to accommodate the various feelings of the segments of the members of the PDP. It is not about a few people who feel that they must have their way. They will sit down and incorporate their strategic interest because of their own ambition in 2019. That's not what it is. Had it been the founding fathers of the PDP, major aim is to satisfy their own personal interests, we wouldn't have had what we have today as a nation. They make tremendous sacrifice, fulfilled their various individual interests to allow the national interest to prevail. That's what happened, and that is what we should do. Anything short of that, there are people who are willing to organize a parallel convention, a parallel structure, so that we the Nigerians, PDP faithful, will see who is doing the right thing or who is doing the wrong thing. Strategically, that's what, and that's what forced them into negotiation. You know, that's what forced them to drop the former position they have taken before. And that's what we've been saying. Lawlessness and impunity, recklessness and vulgarity must stop in this party. It's like we have not learned from our mistake. What led to our defeat? It is this lawlessness, recklessness, rascality, disrespect to the people, disrespect to the members of the party that have been electing the party for 6 years, you know, without any remorse. And this is a sign of lack of remorse by what they try to do. Few people who, you know, one way or another were imposed by certain few governors who benefited from the structure of the party, you know, got into office by the structure of the party, are today trying to distort the history of the party. And we can't stand and allow them to do that.
Well, if we understood him properly, he is saying that, well, he's not saying that they shouldn't zone the positions for 2019 as of yet, but the positions that they have are the ones they should zone. If we do not have those elected positions, he says, why zone them now, that we can zone them when the time comes?
Before convention in 1999, all positions were zoned, including the president. The president was zoned to the south and to the southwest, to be specific. Other vice president was zoned. The senate president was zoned. The speaker was zoned. So it is not true. The records are there. The records are there in our archives. They are there.
Is there any law saying that it must be zoned before the convention?
Yes, that the constitution of the party said zoning, rotation, is very fundamental to the stability, progress, prosperity of the party.
Yes, so, I'm aware of that.
That's what brought the stability of Nigeria.
I'm aware of that. I'm simply asking if there's a time stipulated within the constitution of the party that the zoning must occur.
It's not necessarily about time. It's about when you are about to have election coming, you know, those things are basic. Simply to stop complaints or some people were shortchanged and so on and so forth. The party has to be proactive. You cannot wait until the time comes. You have to deal with issues before they arrive, so that you minimize the level of the level of argument, dissatisfactions here and there, or possible rebellion within the party. You have to accommodate various interests. Nigeria is a big country. Nigeria is not a small country. You must understand the dynamics of the country, the geographical location of the country. You can